I bring greetings from ILBS. Everyone knows about the functions of liver. I just want to give two important parts of it. One, that all the blood clotting and the clotting factors are made in the liver. Second, liver controls your blood sugar. Pancreas produces insulin on the demand based on liver's utilization and control of the blood sugar. In fact, liver is the main organ which controls your energy balance. It is your chartered accountant. What comes in, if it is more, will be stored than what goes out. What damages liver? Simply, we know viruses, hepatitis B or C or A and E, alcohol abuse, and today what we are talking is probably the most common cause of this century is the fat. A normal liver, which is maroon or slightly reddish, about 1200 to 1400 grams, has less than 5% as fat. So if there are 100 cells, less than 5% will have fat. Liver has 10 raised to power 11 cells. Of them, if more than 5%, it is not good. And if it is more than 10%, liver will be slightly large and it have whitish color. Now, this is an ultrasound just to make you understand. This is the skin. This is why it is under the skin. This is the liver and this is the kidney. If liver is close to what is fat here, that it is white, it is echogenic, then it is a fatty liver. Spleen and liver are brothers and sisters, must have same color. So on a gray scale, a routine radiologist can pick up, oh, this is fatty liver. In fact, they can grade it very well. Now you look at the liver and the two most common causes of injury today, one alcohol and one fat. As I said, if it is more than 10% of the cells or 10% of the weight of the liver is fat, it is not healthy. So what will happen? The liver cell, instead of being pink, now has white fat inside. Now this is not accepted by the body. Body says these cells in the liver are not normal. The innate immune cells, the NK cells and other cells will say, oh, this is a bad cell, kill it, remove it. And that killing by inflammatory cells, which is hepatitis, steatohepatitis, is the beginning of the illness. The cells are removed, but in that process, you lay down some fibrous healing, chronic healing by fibrosis, and slowly this fibrosis can turn into cirrhosis, a hard, shrunken, nodular liver. So fat is not liked by the innate cells. Subsequently, adaptive immunity may also come. So pure fat is itself not good. It has its own problems. But once hepatitis, fibrosis, this becomes a fatty liver disease. So the spectrum starts from pure fat, inflammation, fibrosis and scarring, cirrhosis, and then complications like liver cancer and others. What you need to remember is in the beginning itself, when there is more fat, 10% or more, in fact, now even 8% or more of fat. Now, what is the problem? If there is fat, insulin cannot get in. If insulin cannot get in, pancreas will keep on making more insulin. Higher insulin is required to utilize the glucose. Increased insulin production will lead to diabetes. So the fact is, fat in the liver requires more insulin. Slowly and slowly, this will lead to exhaustion of the pancreatic cells. Fat in the liver is also because it is correlated with fat which is circulating in the blood. So fatty liver, you will have high cholesterol, high triglyceride. But look at the other side. Somebody has high triglyceride, he will have fat in the liver. In fact, they go hand in hand. This also will lead to extra circulating fat. This will lead to thickening of arteries, atherosclerosis, heart disease, and stroke. Dr. Duseja will discuss these in greater detail. But just to tell you, everyone may not go this pathway, that hepatitis, fibrosis, cirrhosis. Some of them with just steatosis can have many, many other diseases of metabolic syndrome. Now, once inflammation has started to occur in the liver, you can't do biopsy every time, but inflammation in the liver is easily measured by high SGPT. Normal SGPT, we will come to it, but if it is, let's say, above 40, it means liver cells are dying. The fatty liver is seen in India in about, and globally also, about 30% of the people, 1 in 3. Of them, about 10% or even more may have diabetes. So fatty liver and diabetes have a very close correlation. Why diabetes? I told you there is fat in the liver, more insulin is needed, more cells of pancreas are used, they gradually get exhausted. So today, generally we believe diabetes type 2 is a liver disease. This is a very important slide. In Korea, in 1990, about 1,42,000 health insurance participants were taken between 35 and 59 years. Baseline ALT or SGPT was measured, and these were followed for about 10 years. Now, those who had an ALT of less than 20 had all-cause mortality or liver-related mortality as equal. But if SGPT was around between, let's say, 20 and 29, liver mortality increases. And if it is around 39, 30 to 39, all-cause as well as liver mortality increased. And if it is above 40, you can see how much more problems were there. So now you have a young boy of 30 years who comes to you with an SGPT of, let's say, 60. You can see that his liver related, heart related, other morbidities and mortalities can be very high. So we must now, at least in ILBS, we are using an SGPT or ALT of less than 30 for males, and for females less than 90. This is also used by US. Of course, in India, most people are using 40 for both male and female. I urge that this should be changed. Number two, if somebody has high ALT, means there is inflammation in liver, then the risk of developing diabetes in 10 or 15 years is 5 to 20 times. This is based on Framingham cohort studies in the US. So NAFLD, therefore, is the core to all non-communicable diseases, whether it is cerebrovascular disease, it is hypertension, atherosclerosis, diabetes, or its complications. I have not discussed, but kidney disease, polycystic ovaries, sleep apnea, osteoporosis, and all cancers, as just now Dr. Vashney also stressed. An elevated ALT means liver is inflamed, it can get scarred, and cirrhosis can occur. So NAFLD must be remembered as the core to NCD. Also, the core to reversal of NCD. It can change back. Now, COVID is more severe in NAFLD patients. Everyone today is talking of COVID. But fatty liver is the biggest comorbidity. One third of the people have it. Now, how do you say this? This large data from Hong Kong. Who had more severe and progressive COVID? Age, males, BMI, comorbidity, diabetes, hypertension. But much more or equally more was NAFLD. So those who had NAFLD in the Chinese population had a 6.4 odds ratio of a more severe progressive disease. How pathogenesis, how does this occur? Very simple terms. Liver is the first stop of fat metabolism or calories. What we eat gets absorbed from the intestine and goes through the portal vein into the liver. Liver will metabolize. If it is equal, chartered accountant, the amount you take, the amount you burn is equal, nothing will happen. If it is extra, adipose tissue will store. 3 days of parties and you become overweight. Now this will buffer for some time, but after that, adipose tissue cannot buffer. Extra triglyceride, cholesterol will go into the blood vessels, other organs. On the other hand, there are several people whose adipose tissue is poor. So there is a person who eats, he doesn't have extra fat in his diet, but his adipose tissue is bad because he never exercises, lean and thin, but sedentary. Now this defective adipose tissue will allow directly fat to go to liver or other organs. Adipose tissue will not expand. It has given up. So everything which was to go into the fat bank of the body has gone to liver or other organs. That is why people say, sab patla dubla tha, phir bhi sab heart attack ho gaya, phir bhi liver kharab ho gaya, phir bhi BP ho gaya. This is the group of people, and about 20% of Indians have this. So to understand it slightly more, and this is an important slide, excess calories will go to your fat pads in the abdomen, the white visceral fat. Also, it will go to the liver if more than 5% is bad. Same is true of muscle, more than 5%. Then pancreatic cells and then the blood vessels. So these are sites where fat should not be there. Therefore, avoid extra calories. Now there are three types of people. This is important to understand. People say, sahab, wo to bahut khata hai. He is so overweight, but his liver is all right. Yes, it is possible. He is the type 1 patient. So here, the effect of genes is minimum. He has some metabolic factors, obesity and others, and environmental factors. He doesn't exercise and eats more. He still will survive. But suppose there is a third type of patient. His father had diabetes, father had heart problem, father was overweight, mother was also double, both parents. Now such a person has a strong genetic predisposition, slight amount of metabolic discomfort, overweight, and environmental factor, this person will behave worse than this person. And therefore, we have to understand what are the genetic determinants, not merely phenotypic, lean and obese. So this is the way now we understand obesity. Here is a person who is overweight, BMI is 30 or more, he is metabolically unhealthy. But there can be another group of person who will be overweight, obese, but he's metabolically healthy because he's the first generation kind of a person. On the other hand, there is a person who is normal weight or even lean, but he can be metabolically obese. Metabolically obese means his muscles have more fat, his liver, other areas have more fat. How do we diagnose? First is SGPT or ALT. This will pick up about 20%. But in general population, 10% of the people will be picked up. In diabetics, 20%. Now you do an ultrasound, a simple ultrasound. About 40% of the people who have diabetes may have a fatty liver. Now you do a FibroScan, which is a better machine to check about the fat. Here, diabetic, 70% will have fatty liver, and general population, 30 to 40%. So the best methods today include FibroScan, which is a low frequency ultrasound, a simple ultrasound, or an MRI or MRS. I told you about the ultrasound very well. This is the CT scan. This is the spleen. This is the liver, which is dark. You can pick up the areas of interest, region of interest, compare liver and spleen, and the difference, if it is more than 10 or so, it's not good. So it is a fatty liver, black, dark liver. This is a simple fibro scan. This gives you liver fat. Anything which is less than 250 is good. What is it? Controlled attenuation parameter. When the sound wave goes, it is attenuated. And attenuation means that the amount of fat, if it is, let's say, 350, it is like 60% of the liver may have fat. Now, this is about fibrosis in the liver. An ultrasound wave in a normal healthy liver will take 60 milliseconds to come back. But in a hard cirrhotic liver, it may take just 20 milliseconds. And in a stage 2 fibrosis, it will take, let's say, 40 milliseconds. So the speed of return of the sound determines the stiffness of the liver. So today, we measure liver stiffness and liver fat by FibroScan in maybe about 2 minutes' time. This is an easy and good method. To whom to suspect and whom to refer? First is to change our attitude. Oh, people say, fatty liver hai, koi baat nahi sir, chalta hai. Koi farak nahi padta, bahuton ke hai. Please change that attitude. That approach of ignoring an entity like fatty liver today is not a great idea, because fat in the liver is an alarm for liver triglycerides, blood pressure, cancer, stroke, and many, many other things. It doesn't mean it occurs, but it's an alarm. We have to teach our barbers. You see that black line? This black line and presence of warts means this person may have fatty liver. This is acanthosis nigricans, very well correlated with fatty liver. We also have to teach our tailors. If the waist in a male is more than 90 or in a female more than 80, it's not good. Don't fit jeans onto you, fit into the jeans. So am I having fatty liver? This can be done at a village level, of course, by all the people at all levels. So if there is a family history, I told you type 3 person, phenotype and genotype. So if there is a history of metabolic syndrome, diabetes, blood pressure, heart or kidney disease, liver disease, gallstone. Gallstone is a liver disease. It is a lithogenic, thick bile made by liver. Gallbladder only stores it. Cancers, obesity, and snoring, you know, the sleep apnea, these all suggest that you may have a fatty liver. For weight, remember, height minus 100. This is the standard formula. 170 is your height. Reduce, deduct 100, so your weight should be 70. For a female, deduct 105. And that will tell you if you are overweight, you have a problem. Ultrasound, as I showed you, or a fibro scan if available. SGPT, serum lipids, and a fasting blood sugar will help. Very simple way, in just half an hour, 1 hour, you can say, am I healthy or am I unhealthy? So now, coming back to this new terminology called metabolic associated fatty liver disease, MAFLD. MAFLD is a new term, not globally accepted, but proposed. The importance of this is it helps you in your screening programs all across. So all diabetics, every single diabetic must be screened for fatty liver. At least 70 to 80% will have fat. All overweight and obese. And in India now, being Asian, anything BMI above 23 is overweight and above 25, maybe even obese. So all overweight or obese, all diabetics must be screened for fatty liver. Now a lean and normal weight person with a BMI between 18 and 23, if this person has a waist which is more high BP or high triglycerides or low HDL, such a person would need special screening. So 80% of your people can be covered by simple two groups. And this is the advantage of metabolic dysfunction associated fatty liver disease terminology. We need to detect NAFLD. The need is undisputed. And India, as Dr. Vashne mentioned, has integrated NAFLD into the National Communicable Disease Program. We had just recently on 19th a World Liver Day. I think we have rightly picked up good terms, Fit India, Yoga, Eat Right. When and what to eat is important. Even in the first year of your life, if you give to the child fruit juice twice a day versus once a day, at 5 years, the number of kids who will get fatty liver will be 5 times. Just remember, giving sweet juice to a child once a day versus twice a day. So the science has increased so much that we need to go to the schools, we need to go to the parents, we need to go to our own homes to teach about why and what and when to eat. I will just probably stop here. Last slide is to just say thank you to all the people in Devgarh, especially Dr. Vashne and all the faculty. And I do hope that we will work together. Maybe we can have some joint surveys, joint studies together in your region, and especially the holy place may have many people who are indulging into some extra food maybe. And thank you for giving me the opportunity.